The fact that I'm living with my parents, there's a lot of stigma attached to it. There is a cultural aspect to it where it is required that you take care of your parents. It's a choice. It's a choice that I made to be with my parents, and I'm grateful for this choice. I'm able to save living with my family. I've been able to build a real estate portfolio with 4 investment properties, looking at the 5th one. And I do think my relationship now has been the best with my parents than it has been before. My name is Sal Khan. I am 31 years old. I make $220,000 a year, and I live with my parents in Houston, Texas. I work in tech sales for a software company out in the Bay Area. My base salary is $155,000. The rest is just bonus and commissions. I'm on a 70-30 plan, which means my total comp is 230, but that doesn't mean that I'm capped at 230. I can always exceed the bonuses, and it really just depends. One of the things that they have mentioned to me earlier is, if you have savings, start off real estate investing ASAP. My goal was like to make sure I can have enough savings to go get my first property. For my 4 properties, the approximate net income would be $8,000 for the year. Because of the relationship that we have, it's not like a specific that I have to pay this bills. My parents are very relaxed. So let's say if my parents go grocery shopping, they're not gonna give me like a bill and say, oh, this is the things that we bought for you. Every month, I try to give my mother $200, just like a gift. There has been a couple expenses here and there for my parents' medical, so I was able to fit the bill. I would say my biggest splurge would be eating out and traveling. It was new for me. And I just took it on myself. I didn't hire a property manager. I wanted to do it on my own. I couldn't find a lot of people that would be willing to kind of move in the suburbs. And lo and behold, my sister was in Chicago and she had always wanted to move to Houston. Like the typical landlord relationship is not there, you know, because she's my sister, it's more casual. It's a good relationship and I'm really happy that I got to help my sister and she got to help me. All in all, I would say about 5 hours a week is what I'm spending on the 4 rental properties. Whether it's maybe scheduling a plumber for the rentals, maybe scheduling an electrician if things are not working, or just like checking in to see with some of the investor calls that we have for the storage facility or the rental units. Making money is like you want to be still be able to enjoy it and still have the freedom to enjoy it. So I don't want to overburden myself where it's too intense. So I think the limit in my case would be 10 properties. That is where like I would rather just focus on the 10 and really focus on what I have in my investment portfolio versus going over more quantities. I have 2 brothers and 2 sisters, and I'm the youngest of them. Growing up, it was always a blessing being the youngest just because you learn so much from your older siblings. When I was between the ages of 13 and 18, my parents were going back and forth. So we had some of the family here, and then I was the only one back there because I was still waiting for my sponsorship. I did miss my parents a lot. My mom would come in maybe for the summers and then I was there for the most part. So I got independent quite early, but over there I did have my grandpa. He was my roommate. I was the last one to come to US from the family. I came to US when I was 3 months shy of 21 years old. We're a very close family and we have maintained that till this day. I do feel there is a part of me that makes up for the lost time. It's also the fact that, you know, I'm the youngest in my family, so I would get to spend the least amount of time with my parents. I didn't have that kind of day-to-day relationship. I didn't really, you know, spend time that much bonding that I do have now. So I think that has been the blessing. There was that missing piece where this is an opportunity that we could, you know, use as a family and really improve our relationship. But the fact that I'm living with my parents, there are some adjustments that I'm making, especially when I look at the biggest adjustment would be my dating life. So the person I'm dating now is she's living with her parents, I'm living with my parents. And when we move in together, there's a possibility that her parents, as well as my parents, will be living together. So it's just like one of those things where you just have to find people that understand your situation. I have over $200,000 saved, and that's where I am in the process of getting another property, a duplex here in Houston that I'm actively looking for, and use some of that savings that I have towards the down payment for that duplex. I do plan to move out eventually. I'm thinking in the next 2 to 5 years. I don't have a specific timeline yet. I think for me, it's really more about the financial targets that I'm at. I do want to get to at least $2 million in assets before I move out. So that's my personal goal. I do want to bring in my parents, and that's only because I do take care of them. They love living with me, and they have explicitly mentioned that wherever I go, they want to go with me. So that's the whole part of that, where especially as they get older, there are definitely more needs. And for me, that's like my biggest honor. Like, I get to be with them and spend more time. So that's the idea here, where we do move out, it'll be with me, and we'll go from there.